internet. Gordon Ung and Elaine Yee with PC World here today. We've got a special treat for you. Judy Johnson, Director of Gaming at HP, is going to talk about two things a lot of people on the internet don't believe in. One, why it might actually be better to buy a pre-built computer, and two, why you may actually want to install HP's Omen Gaming Hub on your gaming computer that's not even an HP. But we all know people want to hear about hardware first, since they probably can't buy most of this stuff. So in one of these boxes, you can see Omen's 30L desktop computing. It's actually at Elena's house. She is going to ask the questions about that because I don't even know what it looks like here.
Yeah, I actually was poking around a little bit in it yesterday and started to answer some of my own questions almost. But I thought I'd still just ask you about this pre-built, because I mean, I think a lot of our audience has this image of pre-builts from, I don't know, say 10 to 15 years ago, where everything is proprietary. You can't really swap out parts. You can't really do any upgrades on it. So, I mean, I guess my first question for you is, who do you see as like the core audience for your pre-built gaming PCs these days?
So the core audience for pre-built gaming desktops PCs are the same as the audience for any gaming PC. It's people who want to play games. The difference is there are people that like to go through and research every part and build the PC and install the drivers and have every component customized exactly for them. And there's some people that just like to get a PC and play a game. I've built my own gaming PCs for years. They've been my babies. Got one downstairs. It's my baby. And I get the thrill of being able to do everything that I want myself and have it optimized. But I also understand the desire to be able to have a PC that I just turn on and I can play. And I know that everything has been tested. Everything's guaranteed to run. And I can have a gaming experience right out of the box. So for many, many people identified, gamer used to mean build your own PC, right? There used to be this feeling that when you identified yourself as a gamer, it meant everything from I built my PC and I played. But now we've got an audience that not everybody wants to go through and do all of that research and update the drivers and figure out what component's going to work with what component. They just want to sit down and play. And that's why we create quite a few different models that satisfy a variety of different gamers' needs and a variety of different gamers' budgets.
So are these PCs customizable on the website then?
So the PCs are able to be customized on the website. You're able to do a pre-built. We have configurations already set to say, hey, you can go ahead and buy this pre-built configuration. Or we have customizers that allow you to go through and choose the customizations that you want. I will warn you, I think the rest of the world's seeing this too. Right now, I looked earlier this morning and 7/8 of our desktop options right now are not available on our website just due to supply. It's frustrating. It's frustrating for us too. It's frustrating for people that are out there trying to get a PC. It's frustrating when you want to do the research and configure and see what that means. This is something that we're all working really hard for. We just tell people, you know, just the supply situation changes not even daily, but hourly. Just be out there looking, be ready to pull the trigger.
So I guess that means that even you all don't have much control over what you get in stock when you get it.
Supply chain right now is the global pandemic has really strongly impacted supply chain for everybody. And we're working very closely with our component manufacturer partners to speed up delivery, increase our share of available parts. You know, luckily, we have longstanding relationships across the industry to help keep a steady supply of demand, but we don't have a magic wand. We don't have the ability to say, we need 5,000 more GPUs tomorrow when they show up. There is a demand problem. It's not just a getting supply. It's just being able to get allocation of demand. And I think that's one of the areas that it's nice being HP right now. It's nice the fact that we do have those longstanding relationships. We do have contracts with major suppliers, which help us. And a lot of people are not in this position. So it's nice that we're able in the position to keep supply coming in but obviously not enough.
Kind of circling back to the beginning of the conversation where I mentioned that there are a lot of people who still have this preconceived notion or notion that pre-builts are proprietary, you can't swap things out. I know you already talked a little bit about changing that and so that this Omen in particular uses more industry standard type parts. Can we talk specifically like what those parts are? Like, let's say can I drop in a different processor if I wanted to do that?
Right. I believe the device that you have comes with a Intel Core i9 processor.
Yes.
So, and so I want to go through because they are industry specs inside of this. And so, yes, making sure the Omen 30L, the one that you have, is created to be able to provide a high degree of upgradability. And so that's the processor, the graphic card, the memory, the power unit if you want it to. It comes with the Core i9. It comes with the NVIDIA GTX, RTX, I'm sorry. You've got the RTX 3080. It's got the HyperX 32 gigabyte of RAM. So you've got a variety of industry components that are inside of that that you're able to upgrade. You're able to go through. I see you reaching back.
I'm trying to zoom in a little bit for people. I don't know if this helps at all.
You know, inside of it, we have industry standard ATX power supplies, so you can easily swap them out. They're 80 plus certified, which means they're certified to be energy efficient. The one thing that you come with a pre-built system that you should consider. So for instance, if you were building your own machine, you're going to look very closely about, you know, what power supply based on what graphic card you have and making sure. And say, let's say you went and upgraded your graphics and you needed to have a higher end power supply. You know, this is one of the things we spec our machines to make sure that everything runs great. This is an area that we make sure that everything. So if you were to put in a higher end NVIDIA graphics card in there, that you would have the ability to swap out the power supply because it's an ATX standard to do that. Now, once again, we come with the standard, here's everything's going to work together. It's all spec together. And this is an area that I think people have to realize that they start swapping out components. It's just understanding what's needed to work with each other. The same as a DIY.
One thing I did notice when I was poking around in there is that the motherboard and some of the, even like the small design touches, so to speak, do seem much closer than previous pre-builds I've seen to industry spec, which is very promising. I do find it quite interesting that there are certain things labeled on here, though, that you wouldn't find on a standard DIY PC, which, again, is kind of an interesting discovery for somebody like me, that this kind of straddles the line between the two. And I'm wondering if all of the Omen PCs are like this, and if that's what distinguishes it between the Pavilion line of gaming machines, which I think tends to be aimed much more squarely at a mainstream gaming audience as opposed to a high-end enthusiast audience. And if there are, this is kind of a two-part question, sorry.
Sure.
And then the second half of it is if the another distinguishing factor is customization, like the fact that can I actually add LEDs to this? Can I make it even more unicorn rainbowy if I wanted to, versus like say a Pavilion?
Well, you brought up a Pavilion line, which you're correct. Our Omen line is more customizable. It's more upgradable than our Pavilion gaming line. You know, our Pavilion gaming line. Could be more of a combination of some custom parts to have a value to be able to get a great gaming experience at a lower price point. You know, you can swap out the graphics cards or the CPU or the memory, but you couldn't add a liquid cooler or a system fan that doesn't fit in the chassis. Where we make sure that our Omen devices are able to be, you know, more upgradable, that you are able to, for instance, if you wanted to add a liquid cooler, if you wanted to be able to add more fans, that it's designed for that. The other thing you'll notice on our Pavilion Gaming is they're tiny little boxes, right? You know, you're looking at a 30L right now. Our Pavilion Gaming is a 15L. There's a lot less space in that chassis to be able to go through and add the customizations and the optimizations to it. But we try to make sure there's room inside that 30L so that you can do additional things. You are able to add, as you put it, the fun unicorn touches.
And Lana, can I ask you, when you said that it has, there's labels on there that you might not find elsewhere. Can you give me an example?
Yeah, so unfortunately, I can't quite get the camera in there with the lighting, but I have my handy dandy pointer thing here, so it's not quite so weird. So like right in here is the second SSD slot, like right here, and it's actually labeled SSD2. So if I were to send this to my sibling who wants to play, I mean, right now he wants to play Train Simulator 2 or whatever the game is. But if, you know, my sibling wanted to play something, you know, and called me and said, hey, I need more storage. Where does it go? This would make it so much easier to walk them through it.
You're right. It needs to be something as users go through and look. And that's a difference if we look at our Omen versus our Pavilion Gaming, as we talked about, for the upgradability. I can't tell you that every device has that labeling in it. We try to put those touches, but I can tell you that within our Omens, you know, we try to make sure that like even the motherboard is a standard micro ATX to give the ability to have more options, make it easier. But the standardization or the headers that connect to the case sockets are all standard. So those are the things that are important to make it so somebody feels comfortable that they have the ability to come in and upgrade the devices in the way that they would want to.
Hey, Judy, can I ask a question? As an OEM versus, because this really comes down to OEM versus DIY. That's the common, you know, beef on the internet. I think people don't understand that when you're an OEM, there's a difference between, say, me ordering stuff and building computers and selling them to my friends and family out of my garage. When you get to your scale, can you give us an idea of like the differences like that HP has to follow, whereas I don't have to follow anybody's. There's nothing I got to worry about.
That's a great question, because as an OEM, you know, there's a lot of people that really don't understand what an OEM does versus somebody that just gets components and builds a PC, or what a locum system integrator does. You know, so at a basic, right, we guarantee your box will work. We optimize the drivers. We'll test everything thoroughly. In most cases, I can't say all, but you might pay less for the sum of the individual parts, especially today with a lot of the component prices being what they are. And you get a great gaming out of the box, you know, directly out. But there's other things that are involved here. There are so many regulatory regulations that an OEM has to adhere to. So we have to adhere to the strictest regulatory standards at a global level, being a global company, which means that our products are built to meet regulatory standards in all countries we do business. We have to care not just about the US, EU regulations, China regulations, Japan regulations, et cetera. Tempered glass is a great example. In order for us to ship worldwide, we have to make sure that the regulatory standards for EMI, electromagnetic interference, for all countries is met. And the standard is different in every country. This is something that a DIY doesn't have to worry about. It's something that a system integrator, a local competitor, doesn't have to worry about. And another example is energy. Coming soon, there's a new CEC Tier 2 energy, California energy standard that we're going to need to meet if you want to be able to sell. It's something we totally believe in. You know, one of HP's biggest secret, I think, is how much we do for sustainability. And we think we're on board with the standard, but it's something that we have to worry about that you find that others don't have to worry about. If you're DIY, you probably don't give that much consideration for your component. There's another part that we look at. It's also component quality. You know, we warranty these machines. We're constantly having to fight a publicity battle where we're seen as cutting corners to save a few bucks versus a DIY. And actually a lot has just been true. It's the opposite as an OEM, because we have to make sure that we're able to pull these together. We have to make sure that we're able to test everything adheres to these standards. We're working through a complete solution. So I think in some areas we design everything to the strictest standards that are needed in the world to make sure that things work.
So the example is at the Gordon Ung PC company. The engineer is me. I just order it on Newegg and Amazon. I screw them together. You give me the money, cash only. So you're telling me you actually have to employ engineers to make sure a power supply or voltage regulator and a motherboard or EMF, you actually employ engineers then.
We do. We have to understand what the guidelines are. We have to employ engineers to be able to. We have people that are like looking at everything to design the right power supply for the right system that meets the right energy guidelines and standards for that device. We have to test it. We have to test it to make sure that it works worldwide. There's a lot for an OEM that we need to check. And then obviously we're going to warranty this.
I guess that warranty is better than the Gordon Ung PC company's warranty. Then, so probably.
Which is you break it, you bought it.
Yeah. I know this. You got the wrong number. There's no Gordon Ung here. I don't know.
No, there's additional things in Gordon. I hate to go, but like, we test power consumption. We test cooling. We test a variety of different things. And I know when I built my own computer, I test that it runs, right? I test that it runs, but I'm not testing to a standard spec, right? And that's one of the things that I feel is a little different. We're testing all of these to standard specifications that we need to meet worldwide. And they're the right things. These specifications are the right thing to do.
Yeah, and the power standby is a really good one because, you know, idle power is something that is being cracked down on desktop PCs. That's what you referenced earlier. I don't have to worry about that. I just put in a 1,000-watt power supply that's 80 plus, you know, I don't know, aluminum, not even bronze, and, you know, I'm good to go. So for you, you're forced, before you can even sell that, you have to meet all those guidelines for California, I guess.
Absolutely.
So like power supply, that's it's funny. A lot of this comes down to power supply, but everybody thinks all OEMs just cut corners. And you're saying that's not true. What people need.
Well, we decide what power supply use to in our PCs based on what components are going into the PC. And it really comes down to CPU and GPU components that are going in the box. And so our devices are configurable. We make sure that with the GPU and CPU that you got, you have the right power supply to power your devices. We also make sure that these are customizable. You know, you have the ability when you're going through and you're ordering, if you want to customize, our Omen devices are configurable. The power supplies comes up to an 800 power supply. They use ATX standards. So let's say that you went through and you bought a PC from us that came with the 3060. Maybe a year later, you decided to update to the 3080. It's a little bit more power hungry. That's an area that you could, just like a DIY up front, and go, you know what? I may want to engineer something bigger in the future. When I configure my spec for it, I'll put in a better power supply, a more powerful power supply, or I'll use the one that's spec for it and I'll upgrade things when I come. It's sort of the same when you start looking at the upgrade, you're looking at the same type of decisions. But we go through like I said, we have an engineering team that's looking for the right power supply for the right specification we have to provide a great experience.
You sold me a lot of good reasons to buy the hardware here, because first, you got that 3080 in the machine. You can get it and you're not charging, you know, $1,000 just for the GPU. But this one, this is going to be the hard sell, I think, for a lot of gamers. So you need to convince, you got to sell me on this. You want me, for someone who doesn't own an HP PC, to install Omen Gaming Hub. First, can you tell me a little bit about what it is? And then, I mean, really, that's like me. That's like trying to convince somebody to install a trial antivirus program on my end, right? It's just like most people we know, nobody wants it because the trials are 30 days. But why would anybody want to install Omen Gaming Hub on their non-HP computer?
So let me start a little bit and tell you about Omen Gaming Hub. So Omen Gaming Hub started off as Omen Command Center that was providing software that provided you a better hardware experience. And that's super important. I will say most of us have Nest doorbells or Nest thermostats. And we understand that software is a core part of the experience to provide a better experience. And so, you know, Omen Command Center at the time was set up to be able to say, I've got this great device. I need to be able to configure my lighting on it. I need to be able to to do my performance controls. It requires software to be able to do that. So this is the genesis of Omen Gaming Hub. As gamers' needs have changed, so has the software. And so it's grown as we've looked and said, well, users now want to be able to control their RGB lighting. They want to be able to set up their device. They want to be able to have their memory lights go. They want to be able to have their mouse lights go. And so we've been enhancing Omen Gaming Hub to continue to provide features that were important to what gamers were doing to provide a more enhanced experience. If you've looked at it, everything from being able to say, I have a variety of games. We do a lot of research. We do an awful lot of research into what gamers are doing, what gamers are playing, what they're looking at, the segmentation of the market. We talk to gamers. We talk to a variety of different level gamers and understand. So like, for instance, if you've noticed it, if you've looked at it, one of the first things you'll notice is my games. It's an ability to have a variety of different, all of your games from a variety of different places, whether it's from Steam or Origin or Wii Game or Battle.net or Epic or the Microsoft Store or direct download, being able to have access to everything. So we've looked at what are the experiences that users are trying to just get a better experience. It's not to provide you, I look at, to me, the classic definition of bloatware is somebody giving me something I don't want or I don't need. That's the opposite of what we want to do. We're looking at saying, how do we give you features that you need? How do we give you features to have a great device experience, which would apply more for our devices, things like undervolting and you know, overclocking, to having a great personalization experience, being able to set up your macros, your profiles, your lighting, to be able to have a good gaming experience, what has to do with my games, how I'm playing, you know, being able to create the right profiles for the games experience and to grow from there.
So you can, because I noticed that I installed it on a machine. The Microsoft Store game showed up in the launcher. I also got some Steam games. I didn't have an Epic store, but that is one of these complaints people have, as we've seen, you know, fragmented stores now. Can you launch Epic Store and Steam? And what other games can you launch from within the Omen Gaming Hub?
We support right now Steam, Origin, Wii Game, Battle.net, Epic, Microsoft Store, direct downloads that we find. All of those can be able to be supported because we're trying to solve that fragmentation of you've got a variety of things. We're not trying to, we're very agnostic. We know our gamers play a variety of games. I play a variety of games. They don't always come from one store or one place. And just being able to have access to this. And we're working to bring with more publisher partners to bring games, to bring promotions, to bring discounts, to bring things to the users to be able to help expose them to more games they may not even know of.
So on the Omen Gaming Hub, so you get the unified launcher. Great stuff for people who really hate having to launch multiple markets to play a game. And there's also a game that you're supporting. I was trying to figure out what you get for that. I think it's Road 96. Hopefully I got that right.
So inside of Omen Gaming Hub, like I said, in addition to the feature that you're seeing, the ability to launch, the ability to have, you know, a different type of experience brought to you from gaming experiences, we have the ability to even have we have wallpaper capabilities to bring you wallpapers from the latest games so that you can one touch apply it to your device. We're working with publishers to bring, you know, games to the platform, promotions, discounts to the platforms. And then we're also working with a indie game called Road 96. And with Road 96, Omen Presents. It's something that we're working very closely with them and working with them on the development. Once again, make sure it runs great on our devices. You can get exclusive content for that. So what we do is have a variety of activities planned. We have, you know, exclusive demo planned for Omen Gaming users before anybody else gets to try the game. There's exclusive in-game items, not cosmetic items, but really things that are power-up capabilities inside of this. We'll be giving away content about the game and other material. And we're going to be doing this with DigiCarts and announcing it as they get ready, right? They're in their game development, but things are under development. But it's an experience for us because it's our first time really working this closely with a game developer to see how we can help create better gaming experiences by working directly with the developers. And what does that mean we can bring to our users? You know, can we optimize things on the device? Can we bring bring content that they're interested in getting that it's really hard to get otherwise. How do we continue to provide that? So to us, this is they're a great partner. DigicArts is a great company. We're very excited about Road 96. If you haven't gone out and watched the trailer for the game, you should. It's a very storytelling game. You know, you control the story, you control what's happening, but Omen wants to be part of that. We're looking for all the opportunities to do that.
Okay. So it's actually value add, not just a hat for a game. And it'll be through either one of the stores. It won't be directly from on HP, I imagine.
No, it's not directly from HP. It's a PC game, console game, Stadia game. They're going to be on a variety of different platforms. I didn't think about the hat experience, though, Gordon. I'm probably going to go back and talk to them about that. But we're excited about working, and it's an opportunity for us to try new things with a very exciting game and a very exciting publishing company.
Okay, so my last question about the Omen Gaming Hub is something that is always going to irk somebody. Sounds actually interesting. You may want to install it. People go, okay, I'm going to search for it. I'm going to install it. Takes me to the Windows Store. I don't know where this comes from. I sort of feel it myself. Maybe I've helped to contribute to it, but people don't like to install things from the Windows Store. They like standalone installers. Is it something HP could consider? I don't know why it irks so much, because I've kind of made peace with the Windows Store, but it still bugs me that I have to do it from the Windows Store.
So yes, I totally understand exactly what you're saying. There are a variety of users that feel that the Windows Store is adding a layer of complexity to it. It's something else that you have to do. I have to have this additional login. It made so much sense when we first did Omen Gaming Hub, because it had to do with your device experience, your device configuration. And that's very much tied to your Windows experience. It's one of the things we're looking at. I don't have a firm answer on yet, but we're looking at, as we start to expand more features that are not related directly to your device, but related to your gaming experience, does it make sense that that's the way that users get it? Is it the only way that users get it? Can we see other opportunities? We also know that gamers play in a variety of places. They need content from a variety of places. We have a remote play feature that's on Windows and iOS, on iOS and Android, in addition to Windows. In that case, you're getting it from the app stores. And so how do we provide something more unified? I get exactly what you're seeing, and we're trying to figure out where the obstacles are, what's the best user experience, and how to best meet the needs of this evolving product that we have. And the product, like I said, it's near and dear to our heart. We first started putting out, it provides features for the user. I'll tell you right now, it's got 4.8 or 4.9 stars on the Microsoft Store. It's the number two highest rated app on the Microsoft Store. Hundreds of thousands of apps, and we're number two. It doesn't mean it's most popular. It doesn't mean it's most downloaded, but it means we're trying to make the features that are important to the user to have a high quality experience.
Yeah, you know, and I that's something actually worth noting, because I looked at that review and I was really, really shocked, because if people have never used the Microsoft Store, if you look at reviews of everything, it's like the only people who download applications from the Microsoft Store do nothing but give everything a one. It's like everybody hates every single thing in there. And the fact that you have a 4.8 is really amazing. And it's not 4.8 because it's based on three reviews either. There's plenty of people that have downloaded, but it does kind of speak to it, because there's something about all of the apps that are in there. A lot of people, they're not very kind. They're like restaurant critics or movie critics for the New York Times. They don't like anything. So I'm impressed.
It's not 4.8 in the game category either. It's 4.8 overall. We're second behind Pinterest. I don't think we're ever going to top Pinterest. I'd love to say that we could get number one, but if you use Pinterest, people have this emotional connection to it. I think it's going to be really hard to get past that. But you're right. It's not based on five users. There's over 50,000 reviews in the Microsoft Store. We use that as a barometer, every month as we start to look at it and go, okay, are the things that we're adding the correct things, not the correct things? How do we do that? Because it's important, because it's a validation that our users are having a good experience. It's not the only validation. Like I said, we talk to a lot of users. We go out, we do a lot of testing with what we're doing. but it's important to us. And we want to continue to say, if we're not providing the high quality experience that they want, that's adding a value, then we're not doing the right thing. So you'll see Omen Gaming Hub evolving, and you'll see it evolving to be able to continue to provide more high value experiences, because we want to keep that user satisfaction that we have today.
Hmm. And how much do you have to pay to install this from the Omen, from the store, Judy?
It's free. It's a free download.
Okay. So it's actually worth giving a shot, because I think, you know, people are very skeptical about installing, you know, software that's from an OEM, but there sounds like there's a lot of upsides to it. So might be worth a shot. Maybe you've convinced me. I want to try it on a gaming machine, because I installed it just on an Ultrabook. I do want to try it on a real gaming machine to see what it's like. So my last question for you, Elaine, I want to just close off with a couple of, you probably saved up some questions. Judy, what's your game? I need a new game to play, but tell me what's the hot game right now that you're playing?
Oh my God, I wish it was a hot game. I've been playing still more, you know, I play Call of Duty quite a bit, but I've also been playing, I like Red Dead Redemption, because I feel like I can just get in the game and my favorite thing is I took my horse out and I'm just riding along on my horse. I spent hours just riding around on my horse, and I stopped in this bar and I'm having a drink, and this lady walks in front of me and she coughs. And then I didn't realize my health started going down. I'm like, why is my health going? Well, I died of tuberculosis to cut to the story. But the fact is that the story provides such, you know, ability to have that. It's just such an experience that you can play the game or you can explore the game. And it just kind of keeps bringing another facet. And I'm looking forward to the next thing too. You know, I'm probably one that switches about every 6 to 8 months, but I haven't found my next thing yet.
Okay. Well, you're a Call of Duty person. I'm a Battlefield person. So obviously we're in a rebuilding season. So I'm hoping the next one will bring it back. So
I've heard good things.
Let's all hope.
I have a question related to what you just said about Red Dead. Are you playing the single player? Because I've been doing online, and I don't think I've ever had that happen to me. I've had a lot of horse collisions. Okay. A lot of horse collisions on my end, but no dying of tuberculosis yet.
I'm super embarrassed to tell you, it took me a little while before I mastered being out on my horse. I know that sounds really strange, but I had quite a few horse episodes, and I'm glad other people didn't get to see those.
At this point, I actually end up streaming this with my friends just for fun. And there's video proof of the number of times that I have taken a spill with my poor horse. I think it just wants to be stabled at this point. Just like, don't ride.
I know. It took me a while, and I was convinced I was going to master that. I'm like, I can't not get past this part. So I totally understand.
I'll have to see if I can get sick now. Just cause.
You know, it was random. It was just this totally random experience, but it made me love the game to go, wow, I just happened to notice that she coughed when she walked by.
It's a cool detail.
Yeah, that's definitely very 1800s, right? That's just like, oop.
I hope so.
Wear your mask.
Well, anyway. I love that. Yeah, wear your mask. That would be funny, right? If you could wear it in the mask. Too realistic. But anyway, thanks, Judy Johnson from HP, coming by for talking about the stuff, valuable insight. And so if you got a chance, check out the Omen Gaming Hub. It's free. You can see if it's worth it or not. And of course, look, they got 3080s in their boxes.
Yeah, even comes with a GPU support bracket. So you don't have to worry about SAG.
Yeah, you know, great. Gordon Ung PC Company, there. We don't do that. We don't do that, so...
Yes, check out the 30L. It's a gorgeous machine. It comes with so much that you don't expect. I'm glad, Elena, that when you dug into it, you were pleasantly surprised. We're very proud of this machine, and I think anybody that takes a look at it will be very surprised by the offering that it has and the great package that it comes in.
Well, thanks for coming by. Check back on PC World for more awesome PC coverage.